Composite is the most important material in construction. Every year, 25 million tons are used in UK only. That's why you need to know what it is, what types of concrete are used, and why the right mix is so important. So let's go! My name is Greg and welcome to SiteEng. So what the concrete is really? The concrete is a composite material where the cement is the matrix and the aggregate is the filler. To make it simple, guys, we need the cement, we need water, we need the fine aggregate, which is typically sand, and we need a coarse aggregate, gravel or some type of stone. To give you a rough idea about the proportion of this, I used a very old formula which says 1, 2, 3, where 1 was the cement, 2 was the sand, and 3 was the aggregate, and then we need the water, of course. In general, concrete is a great construction material which is easy molded, easy formed, and still relatively cheap. Every year here in UK only, we're using 25 million tons of ready mix concrete. So it's crazy, guys. Let's talk now about the concrete strength, which is the most important property of concrete, really. And I'm gonna be talking about FCK, which is the characteristic strength of concrete, like C1620, C3037, C4050, or C5060. So what does it mean, really? So C4050, that means that after 28 days of curing, your concrete should achieve a compressive strength of 40 and 50. So the reason why we have two numbers here, it's because we got different samples of concrete. And in first case, with this 40, it's for the cylindrical sample, where we're gonna be compressing actually the cylinder made of concrete. And the second number, 50, is actually for our lovely cube here. And we're gonna be actually, as a site engineers, as working on site, gonna be mostly interested in this number, so the second number. And what it really means is a 50 newtons per millimeter squared. So that's the pressure actually, so that's the compressive strength of it, called sometimes 50 megapascals as well, or 50 kilonewtons per meter squared. So guys, generally speaking, what you're gonna be looking for is actually, you're gonna be looking for the minimum 50 newtons per millimeter squared. So that's the minimum concrete strength you're gonna be looking actually after crushing the cube after 28 days. And if you look at the graph, guys, actually 95% of all the concrete poured should be more than your 50 newtons per millimeter square. So it's only 5% of concrete that you can be a little bit below your characteristic concrete strength. So please make sure on site that your cubes are correctly made and correctly stored before you send them to the laboratory for the crushing. Another way of measuring the concrete strength on site really are the thermocouples, and these are the sensors which you're putting into the concrete while you're pouring. And then guys, based on temperature of concrete, you got the live graph of growing strength of concrete, and this actually is perfect for early strike and stuff like this. And these guys are typically calibrated at the beginning of the job to make sure that you got the closest result based on that temperature, really. And if you want to know a little bit more about it, I'm gonna leave the link below in the description so you can have a look yourself. So let's go, guys, to the concrete mix now and what it really is. So the concrete mix is actually the design formula matching the particular job, the particular environment, and actually the particular element to be constructed. So first thing, I'm gonna start from water to cement ratio. You can see here a fragile relationship. I found this nice page here. I'm gonna leave the link below. You can see here water with cement always come together, but as you can see here, there's a nice graph here. I want you to remember this actually. You can see here the weight and the proportions here are shown to 0.45 to 0.473 and maximum to 0.52. As you can see, the more water we're gonna be adding, the less compressive strength we're gonna get. And this is actually pure weakening of concrete, guys. And as I mentioned in the last of my videos, guys, we as a site engineers, we need to keep an eye on this, as guys really try to add in water sometimes when they shouldn't do it. Please remember, don't add water to concrete, as the one you're getting on site, that's the ready mix, just to be poured straight into the element. So when you're gonna be building by the sea, you need actually some resistance to the salt, really. And if you're gonna be putting your concrete into the ground, you need some resistance for the different attack. And for all this situation, guys, you're gonna see actually the concrete exposure classes, which are gonna be resisting corrosion or some other chemical attack. And I'm gonna leave the table in the description, guys, as well, so we're gonna have a look. But there's like XA, XS, XD, meaning the different type of cause of corrosion. When we talk about the mix, guys, one of the important things as well is the aggregate size. And this is dependent of the element you're gonna be pouring, actually. As sometimes the congestion of the steel is so big that you actually need the smaller chip, the smaller stone. So that might be actually the 10 mil aggregate. Typically what you're gonna find on site is a 32 mil stone, 20 mil stone, and 10 mil gonna be, as I said, in the cases of steel congestion. When you wanna make sure the concrete is gonna be filling all the element and the concrete gonna be getting just in between the steel and everything gonna be working as designed. Let's go now to the concrete slump. And this is a big thing for us, especially where we're working on construction site, as we wanna make sure our concrete is workable to the point we want it. And for these guys, we should actually slump each lorry of concrete coming onto the site. And as you can see on this video, that's the concrete sample here. That's how it's made, really. And that's the way you're going to be measuring this. And then later you're going to have a look if you are actually in the range of your concrete slump. So let's have a look at the table here now, what concrete consistencies we have here, what we're going to be looking for, and what's going to be actually our target slump when we're going to be measuring. So on sites, really, we're actually going to be mostly working with the S2, S3 classes. But I'm going to show you this so you can see S1 is actually target slump is just 20. So that's a very dry mix. So as we go from number 1 to number 5, really, they're going to be more wet and more wet concrete. So the class S2 is going to be, the target slump going to be 70. But if you're between 50 and 90, you're still actually all right for it. That should be still your concrete you are looking for. In case of S3, guys, we're actually aiming for 130, but we are still good to go between 100 and 150. And this is obviously, guys, a recommended range here, but let's say if you're going to be 95 and you're going to be looking S3, you're probably still good to go for it, but you need to be very careful and have a look at this. But once you measure from 100 and 150 in terms of S3, you're just good to go and you don't need to really think about it too much. So from site engineering side, from construction side perspective, guys, what you're going to be looking for, you're going to be looking for some pumpable mix. And you want to make sure when you're using a concrete pump, or you have, especially when you have a long line of concrete, you want to make sure you got a pumpable mix for it. And the details for the mix, you're probably going to work out actually with your concrete supplier, and then you're going to get it approved by designer. But that's very important, guys, as you don't want any blockage on sites, and they really happen sometimes. So guys, I could be talking hours and hours about the concrete, about the cement. So let me know if you wanted more videos like this, and if you want any particular information about the concrete now, leave the comments below with the questions. And as always, guys, just don't forget to leave the thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to join the best community of engineers here in UK.